Okay, guys, first I have to thank some other people for their very inspirational videos, especially John Bedini and IBP Pointless 2 and Dieflyfish. Hey, Dieflyfish, tell us how you get 3 volts from a magnesium carbon cell. That's really a great voltage. I'm very curious how you are doing it, what kind of mix you're using, and who else? All the guys which I have linked at the left side in the menu at overunity.com. So many to mention. Plengo is very good now with the cells, and who else? Just look at the left side of the menu and you will see the guys who are doing great work in this moment. Chuck H was with John Bedini together. But I still don't believe that your magnesium is not consumed, but I will try it because I also have some Epsom and Alaun salt now. And yeah, we will see if the magnesium gets consumed or will not get consumed. Now here, those are the rods with now the black layer on it, with a table salt in it in the vinegar solution. It now has a good black layer, and I have to wait till it's dried a bit. And the other here is still going. And ja, also nochmal auf Deutsch, ja, ich muss erstmal meinen Dank an die ganzen Leute, die Links im Menü bei overunity.com verlinkt habe, aussprechen, an IB Pointless, Plengo, John Bedini und Chuck H und wie sie alle heißen. Wirklich sehr inspirierende Arbeit mit diesen Batteriezellen, aber auch Walter Hoffmann muss ich danken, der mir vor ein paar Jahren, ich glaube 2007, haben wir das schön gemacht mit diesen Durafix-Rod, diesen Aquazellen, haben wir schon ein bisschen rumgespielt, damals alle immer nur mit Salzwasser. Deswegen sind die Dinge halt auch mal verreckt nach einer Weile. Oder haben sich die Stäbe halt aufgelöst in wie so eine Art Zinkchloridkristall. Ihr müsst einfach mal zurückgehen, dann, just in English again, I also have to thank Walter Hoffman from Florida. He showed me already in 2007 how to do these aqua cells, he called it, with the Durafix rod and salt water, but these died because the salt water finally decomposed these Durafix rods. And now we will see with maybe alum or Epsom salt if we can stop these corrosion. We will just see. And here are still some brand names. These are Geoconda 6 artist leads. These are these big pencil leads again. 6 pieces in this package here. Here. And you can also use cheaper ones, but these are very much smaller. 0.5 millimeters, 12 tubes, also very many in here, and only 50 cents and Woolworths. I think Woolworths you have also in the USA. Vom Krabbeltisch hier bei Woolworths, die 50 Cent Pencil Leads, also die Schreibminen hier, Graphitminen, oder hier aus dem Artist-Laden, also Artist-Shop, Geoconda 6 Artist-Leads. Wie dick die jetzt und eigentlich sind, aber bestimmt so 5 mm oder so. 5,6 mm, 6 Pieces, Hardness 2B. B is better than HB, because B has more graphite. HB has more Talcum, only what was it called? It's clay, you know, clay. Also die B-Typen sind immer besser als die HB-Typen, weil HB heißt immer hart und Die haben dann mehr Ton drin, deswegen leiten die nicht so gut. Also immer B benutzen möglichst. Also 6B would be the best, but I only have 2B. The B is the more B would be 6B would be the best graphite content. The less B you have more clay in it and then the conductivity goes down. Okay, so I have to thank all the other guys on the forums and who do great work, and I really hope I can join in it, and in the next video I will show how to do these cells then finally. Okay, thank you, bye bye.